Hey YouTube, how you guys doing today? Kevin here, coming back at you with another video. So we're gonna go over a little recap on the Andrew build. This is my son's bike I'm building for him, and as you guys know from previous videos, I have the Kawasaki KV75 and we put the matching tanks on him. The difference in the bike is mine has a quick disconnect for the seat, his seat's bolted down. This is an actual MT1. And you can see the 75 tank. We're going to get that same decal, but it's going to say 50 on it. All right, so we've been building this bike, and we put in the charge coil to power the lights. That is a Suzuki engine built for Kawasaki. And one of the biggest things on this bike was, is that charge coil going to work? Now, that charge coil that's on this bike is from an MT1 or a KV75. And we drilled and tapped and modified, and we did all kinds of work to get that to fit in the flywheel. And so one of the things we were waiting for to even start this bike was a coil wire that was long enough, because the factory CDI coil had a shorter wire to it, a shorter lead. So this lead right here is off of a scooter, off of one of those Chinese scooters. So we got that on here with the factory cap screwed in there with the grommets. Couple of things that we've done to this motor was we put the it came with the CDI ignition, but we put a brand new carburetor on it, which looks like it's might be crooked. We're gonna have to loosen up that clamp and straighten it real quick. We're gonna try to fire this thing. We ran the line on one of my previous videos. We got the oiler all bled out. But I haven't started this engine yet. There's no exhaust on. The exhaust is going to be on this side right here, where it's going to be the factory pipe. It's going to come up and come down and loop in. So that's kind of a hairy thing at the moment, but we're going to maybe try a couple of different techniques with the exhaust on this, but nevertheless, it'll be on there properly. So, but the main thing today is to start this bike, see if the headlight comes on and if the push button kill switch works. That's would be a horn button on a regular bike, but on the KV75 and the MT1s, that's the off button, that's the kill switch. So I'm gonna get you guys in the stand and I'm gonna go get a screwdriver and straighten out that carburetor before we fire it. All right, I got you guys in the stand. Prior to building this bike, I tested that headlight when it was off the bike. I pulled it off to check it, make sure that the headlight was actually good. That's always a good thing to do if you're working on a bike and you're not sure about the headlight. So let's see here. So this clamp, I just gotta rotate this carb a little bit, just like that, so it sits flat. And then tighten it up, of course. I have not adjusted this carburetor or did anything to it. This is a Chinese carburetor. I paid 21 bucks for it, brand new, on eBay, and it came with the whole air filter assembly. And coincidentally, the the KDX50, the LT50, and the Junior 50 all take the same setup. So the same cob. So it's been sitting with fuel in it. I'm in t-shirt weather, so we're gonna try it without the choke, see if it fires. And I'm not gonna run it long because it's got no exhaust on it. That's not a good thing to have happen. And we are looking to see if the headlight comes on, and that will let us know that the charge coil is all set. So let's fire this thing up. Like I said, it hasn't been started, guys. There we go. Hey, look at that, the headlight's working. And the tail light. Now we want to see if it'll shut off. and shuts it right off. All right, so we got the electrical. We got the electrical all done in the first shot. Awesome. So we have the headlight working. We have the tail light working. And we have the kill switch working, which is awesome. Now these two switches here are on and off for the headlight. And this is high and low beam. So I can't complain, guys. So the bike is running. Wow, that's it. That's what it took. I'm stupefied. So this was the Andrew's bike's first start right here. I thought I was going to have to go in and adjust the carburetors. Just need to be primed up, kicked it a few times, and boom. So I wonder how it'll restart now that it's all primed up. Yeah, it's got to be adjusted. The throttle's going to be adjusted a little bit, but nothing dramatic. Nothing a screwdriver can't fix, right? Hold on. Okay. So we have the idle mixture screw here. And then we have the carburetor curb idle here. Oh, that's really in there. It's kind of tight. So let's see if that helps anything. If not, then we'll go to plan B, right? That's it, guys, right there. We don't want to let it run too long without the exhaust. But, guys, that's it. Put a fork in it. It's done. Well, for the most part. So we got to do tires, a rear brake cable, and we got to do a chain, finish off the exhaust and that front motor mount. So I started off with just the two back ones holding it on there. It's a 50cc, so I didn't think it was going to rip anything apart. And that, my friends, is where we left off on this bike. Kind of a short video. I'll shut the fuel off. But yeah, guys, I am stupefied. This thing is awesome. 50cc, running, whole new top end, under 50 bucks. The whole carburetor, air filter assembly, under 25 bucks. The engine was on eBay for $299. I got it for $250. I can't complain. Little parts and pieces I'm into, like the intake and the gasket, and that little, which came with that little the factory spring clip for the coil wire. I'm into that right there for that whole thing. I think was like 12 bucks. Really not into this thing for at all, hardly any money. The fuel line and the filters. I got the filters on Wish. I bought 10 of them, and I think I paid like $2.99. The fuel line, I bought that right there at the parts store. That was 11 bucks for 5 feet. I got 5 feet, not all for this bike, but for the other bikes as well. So the headlight works. I paid, oh, by the way, I paid 40 bucks for this bike. Without the engine. So it had that tank. It had that seat. It had the headlight. I'm sorry, it didn't have the seat. That seat came off the other bike. But the seat that was on this bike was in just as good condition. Just a little faded. So the only things I put on this bike frame from the other bike I got was the tail light and the seat. But I paid 40 bucks for everything else. And I couldn't be more happy. Which I also got online. So, guys, it's up and running. I am crazily happy. My son is going to love his first bike. So a couple things coming up on the bike. We got to finish the mount, the engine mount. We got to finish the exhaust. And then the engine part is done once we put the chain on. That's the final touch on that. Then we got to do tires and tubes, a brake cable. I already said the exhaust. And then we're going to buy some training wheels for this bike and put the training wheels on it for him. So this bike right here, he'll be able to ride around and then I'm going to take and put this bike in my lineup, take a photo of it, so he's got this bike with dad's bike, you know me, and then I'll probably just do a photo shoot with the two bikes side by side, an actual KV75 with this style tank on it and this particular bike, and do some pictures like that. But I am very happy with the way this bike has turned out. It's been absolutely amazing. So I was able to modify that ignition, the charge coil. The lights work. Very, very happy with that. Very happy. So now his bike is, you know, it's going to be right there. So there is no battery in this system. The faster you spin the engine, the brighter the lights. I believe this bike is going to be doing about 25 to 30 miles an hour with that motor. It came off of, like I said, it came off of an actual bike. So it's not like I'm putting a lawnmower engine on a bike. I'm putting an actual engine on a bike. And this is really, really cool. So we're going to do a couple of versions of this bike. I got another frame that I'm going to use. It's a rolling chassis. And we're going to put a Predator engine on that one. But I just picked that one up. So that's going to be sitting for a little while. That's next year. We're going to do one of those bike builds. But I'm going to put a charge coil on it. We'll see. We'll see what we're going to do. But this Cowie is cowified. There we go. So anyway, guys, thank you for watching. Thanks for subscribing. Thank you for sharing my channel. And guys, this has been a great, great thing. We're not done with it yet, but I'm going to keep doing videos on it. I just wanted you guys to hear the first run on it. So thank you guys for hanging with me. Talk to you later. Bye.